Hello and welcome to the session on Computer Assisted Instruction or CAI. Due to exploration of knowledge, most of the countries in the world face the rise of globalization. For proving the worth of their country, education infrastructure and equality of education of that country is emphasized. Use of adaptive technology and situational learning are the main strategies for exploration of knowledge in such a context. Use of computers in educational settings is one such example. Computers have become an essential part of modern life. Skills to use them have become as basic and common as reading and writing. Computers are a familiar sight in the classrooms of the 21st century. Computers have great potential for computation, analysis work, as well as instructional purpose. Use of computers in education started in the 1960s. The 20th century has witnessed an entry of computers in the field of education for serving different purposes. With advent of microcomputers, its use has become widespread from primary education through the university level. Studies have been taken place during the last few years on how effectively computers have been used in educational field. Computer aided instruction or computer assisted instruction CAI, also known as computer based instruction or CBI, is diverse and is rapidly expanding spectrum of computer technologies that assist teaching and learning process. There are different ways in which computer can be used for educational purpose, and not every use of a computer in the classroom is considered computer assisted instruction. CAI is that form of an interactive instructional technique whereby computer is used to present the instructional material through a computer program to a passive student, or computer becomes the platform for an interactive and personalized learning environment. Teaching to different levels of ability, background and interest has posed an eternal dilemma to educators. Instruction that is appropriate and beneficial for one student may not be for another. It is not practical to tailor classes or lessons for each and every student, and in such cases, compromises are necessary. With computers to help in instruction, the learning of one individual will never be hindered by abilities or weaknesses of others. This is because computer programs are interactive and can illustrate a concept through attractive animation, sound, and demonstration. Computer-based tools and applications are used to assist the teacher or school administrator in the management of the learner and instructional process. Individualized instruction, self-learning, psychological-based learning, and development of cognitive domains are demands of the present day with advancement of technology in the world. To pace with this advancement, CAI can become a solution. CAI is that in which the teacher uses computer at different times and spaces according to the characteristics of the subject matter, the students, the available software and the hardware. Before developing a CAI, the teachers will have to do the following. The first and foremost thing a teacher should do is to identify the problem, that is, to select the areas necessary for the students or where the students find it difficult to learn. It is in this area that the CAI has to be developed. After the problem is identified, some objectives are to be designed related to the problem. After completion of the program material, it should be programmed with the help of computer software to convert it into useful form. Different softwares like Excel, PowerPoint, PageMakers, Microsoft Office, Flash, and many other graphical softwares can be used to develop this AI. Use of computers in instruction. Computers are useful in the instructional process as follows. For an attainment of higher level objectives of cognitive domain, as an integrating tool for combining subjects such as mathematics, languages, biology, social studies, etc. To enhance learning process among school students, to solve problems at higher secondary levels used for various instructional purposes where students can achieve different skills and useful for students of visual arts through computer graphics. Types of computer assisted instruction. Instructional computers are basically used in one of two ways. Either they provide a straightforward presentation of data or they fill a tutorial role in which the students are tested on comprehension. Information that encourages interaction can be easily presented on computers. These can be presented in the form of text, multimedia format, photographs, videos, music, games, speech, animations, etc. Computer assisted instruction system fall into two basic types, tool or tutor. In the tutor classification, the computer has the information to be learned and controls the learning environment. In this classification, there are different modes. They are the following: drill and practice, tutorials, simulations, games, discovery, and problem solving. Drill and practice. Typical instructional media used with CAI has been drill and practice software presentations. Drill and practice is also known as drill and kill. This can be used in all subject areas. It is suited to the behavioral model with repeated practice on lower level cognitive skills. These do not require instructor facilitation or a two-way exchange of ideas between the teacher and the student. The guided drill is a computer program that poses questions to students, returns feedback, and selects additional questions based on students' responses. Drill and practice CAI has primarily been a learning method where information is presented and repeated until a certain level of student achievement is attained. Recent drill systems incorporate the principles of education in addition to subject matter knowledge into the computer program. Drill and practice CAI procedures can be best used for students with learning disabilities. Computer assisted instruction can positively impact reading achievement for students with disabilities. Such students with disabilities can be given instruction focusing on skills such as vocabulary, language, word recognition, reading, comprehension, and higher order thinking skills. Tutorial. This model is one of the most common ones within CAI. In this mode, the computer presents the information, guides the learner through the system, and allows the learner to practice and then assess themselves. Tutorial activity includes both the presentation of information and its extension into different forms of work, including drill and practice, games, and simulation. The tutorial program in a computer works in the following manner. The student is asked a question by the computer and the student is asked to type the answer for it. If the answer is correct, the student is given more challenging questions or problems. The various computer messages will indicate the flow in procedure and the program bypasses more complicated questions until the student shows mastery in that particular area. Simulations. In the simulation mode, the learner works with a simulation of the real world. The simulation software can thus provide an approximation of reality. This type of CAI is used where it is not practical or feasible to provide the learning in real life. Computers can help visualize things that are difficult or practically impossible to view. The simulation mode CAI does not require the expenses of real life or its risk. Explorations and manipulations of simulated environments can be accomplished with the CAI, ranging from virtual laboratory experiments that can be too difficult to complex virtual worlds. For example, simulation models are usually used in pilot training where they are used to show a virtual environment. They are also used to display human anatomy, molecular structures, etc. Games. Games mode is generally competitive. It often creates a contest wherein one has to achieve the highest scores. This mode has time constraints. Discovery. This approach gives large database of information on a specific content. Then the learner is challenged to analyze, infer, compare and evaluate based on the explorations they make with the data provided. Problem solving. This approach helps children develop specific problem solving skills and strategies. The CII programs in the simulation mode and game mode is difficult to develop, but the learners tend to find them more entertaining and challenging. CII systems can be categorized based on who controls the progression of the lesson. Early systems were linear presentations of information and control was directed by the author of the software. In modern systems like that in visualization systems and simulated environments, control often is done by the student or the instructor. Whereas, the tool classification helps in enhancing the teaching process, usually by focusing on one particular learning task and aims to improve it. CI tools such as word processor, spreadsheets, Excel sheets, databases, etc., collects information, organizes it, analyzes and transmit information. They also help facilitating communication among students and between the students and instructors. Advantages of computer assisted instruction. Computers play an important role in different fields of education. Role of computers in educational instruction is very much talked about nowadays. Computers seem to be acquiring increasingly vital role in the classroom instructional process. Computer assisted instruction is an instructional program where materials for instruction are presented by means of a computer. The potential benefits of computer assisted instruction cannot be underestimated in the contemporary world. It plays a very big role in helping teaching content to students in a class effectively than traditional method. It can be used effectively to address academic and communication and language skills. The main aim of computer assisted learning is to meet the needs of the individuals, which are often a difficult task for the teachers. Learners' achievement depends on certain characteristics such as his intelligence, motivation, personality, interest in particular subject, aptitude, etc. But with the CAI, the learner can learn the contents as per his own capacity. He can also repeat the task if he is unable to understand it. The CAI program can adapt to the abilities and preferences of the individual student and increase the amount of personalized instruction a student receives. Students who are shy and those who are slow learners benefit the most from a private learning environment. The learner can spend more time on those topics that are causing difficulty. Information can be reviewed and tasks can be repeated until the learner is happy to move on to a new topic. The CII method makes subjects more interesting and develops a favorable attitude towards the subjects taught in this method. Computer learning experiences often engage the interest of students, motivating them to learn and increasing independence and personal responsibility for education. It increases motivation by providing a context for the learner that is challenging and stimulate curiosity. The CII method helps the students to understand the concept due to incorporation of graphical and numerical approach. Continuous interaction can be made possible with this type of instruction. Moreover, the CAI is time saving because computers can virtually perform miracles in processing performance data. Computers are tireless and can work and instruct at any time under any circumstances. Burnout for this type of instruction can be remedied by simply replacing the machine with another or either replacing a part of it. Computer assisted instruction add action to the information which students receive through one-way process and help students to see the unseen, to test the theoretical concepts and to comprehend abstract ideals. It can dramatically increase a student's access to information. Moreover, the multimedia helps to understand difficult concepts through multisensory approach, and the students can decide when and where to learn. Computer-assisted instruction improves instruction for students with disabilities, language limitations and physical limitations because students receive immediate feedback. A well-designed and implemented tutorial CAI used as a supplement to traditional instruction can produce educationally significant improvement in student examination achievement. A great deal of research has been conducted during the 1970s, 80s and 90s on the effect of computer use on students' achievements and their learning rates. Studies have been carried out extensively to find out the effectiveness of CAI in terms of achievement of students in learning as a substitute for traditional method of teaching. Researchers on computer-assisted instruction have shown that CAI is most successful with early childhood through secondary age learners. But depending on the targeted skill and the needs of the learner, CAI may be used with nearly any age. Apart from all the advantages above, numerous studies have reported that CAI is successful in raising examination scores, improving student attitudes, and lowering the amount of time required to master certain material. Teaching through computers has been found effective not only for academic achievement, but also for some other aspects like interest and attitude. Computer-assisted instruction has also been growing in use in a wide number of employment areas. It has been used to teach novice nurses how to perform intravenous injections, to teach jet engine machines in the Air Force maintenance task, and to provide safety instruction for food service workers in urban hospitals. The commonly known encouraging advantages of CAI are individualized instruction, self-paced learning, content consistency, lower cost, learner tracking, human-computer interaction, and ability to present educational content in a variety of ways. But of all the advantages that computer will deliver to education, the foremost will be their capacity to act as individual tutors. On the whole, it can be inferred that teaching through computers is effective in terms of students' academic achievement, and it helps in increasing conceptual understanding. Limitations of computer-assisted instruction. There are drawbacks to the implementation of computers in instruction, however. The main problem with using computer-aided instruction is the difference in memories in computers and those of humans. Anything in a computer memory can be erased completely. Other disadvantages of CAI stem from the difficulty and expense of implementing and maintaining the necessary computer systems. They are generally costly systems to purchase, maintain, and update. Computer-assisted learning need not be interesting and useful to all those who are exposed to it. Only personalization of information allows computer-assisted instruction to increase learner interest in a given task. With the diversity of students increasing every day, it is practically not possible to personalize the information that is to be instructed for each and everyone. There is possibility that one may be overwhelmed by the information and resources available. CAI should be used to supplement, not replace, traditional reading instruction. Teachers who use CAI often should implement it as an addition to their regular reading program. The children using CAI thus should be able to receive additional instruction and practice in reading. The overuse of multimedia in instruction may divert the attention of the students from the actual content. While using CAI in classrooms, it is necessary that the student also gets trained in the computer technology. This process can distract them from the core education process. Ideally, the aim of CAI is to accommodate all the learners, but this may be a hard thing to do. Not all learners adapt equally well to the computer or web learning environment. It may be difficult for many students to adapt their learning style to computer assisted instructions. This can cause anxiety, which can inhibit knowledge acquisition in the learners. If tried to move again with such students, can cause undue stress on the learner. It is also felt that learning becomes more mechanical with computer assisted instruction. There are also fears, whether justified or not, that the use of computers in education decreases the amount of human interaction. Human instructors will no longer have a class when computers are fully used for instructional purposes. It is not necessary that every teacher knows how to make the best use of computers. Lack of proper infrastructure in schools and teaching institutions may also cause a problem. Non-availability of good CAI packages would be another limitation. It is criticized by many that poorly designed CAI systems can dehumanize or regimen the educational experiences. It thereby reduces interest of learning in students and get demotivated. In some applications, especially those involving abstract reasoning and problem solving processes, it is found that CAI has not been very effective. Conclusion. Though the studies find that CAI may not be suitable to all learning styles, the motivated learners who require specific instruction in a sequential format and enjoy frequent feedbacks will generally benefit for computer aided instruction. In a CAI environment, it is important that the CAI program is easy to use and reliable. A good CAI program should be aware of the different learning strategies that exist and which ones are more effective in a given situation. Such a program should be able to aid the learner by informing them of the various strategies and presenting them at the appropriate points throughout the program. Let me summarize the session. Computers have become an essential part of modern life. Skills to use them have become as basic and common as reading and writing. Computers have great potential for computation, analysis work, as well as instructional purpose. Use of computers in education started in the 1960s. Computers are also used for instructional purposes in the educational field. Computer-aided or computer-assisted instruction, or CAI, also known as computer-based instruction, or CBI, is diverse and is rapidly expanding spectrum of computer technologies that assist teaching and learning process. CAI is that form of an interactive instructional technique whereby computer is used to present the instructional material through a computer program to a passive student, or computer becomes the platform for an interactive and personalized learning environment. The chapter deals with CAI and its various types, the advantages and disadvantages in using computers in instructional purposes are also mentioned in the chapter. Now, you can try to answer the questions given here. What do you understand by computer assisted instruction, or CAI? Why is it useful in the present scenario? What are the processes that a teacher should take care of before developing a computer assisted instruction, or CAI? What is the difference between tutorial model of computer assisted instruction and simulations model? What are the limitations of computer assisted instruction? What are the advantages of using computer assisted instruction in classrooms, and how it benefits the learners? Hope that you may go through these reference books for further understanding. Effectiveness of computer assisted instruction blended with classroom teaching methods to acquire automotive psychomotor skills, written by Gilbert D.W. and published by ProQuest Information and Learning Company, Ann Arbor, in the year 2006. Information Technology and Education, written by Mahapatra B.C. and published by Sarup and Sons, New Delhi, in 2005. Information and Communication Technology in Education, Interactive Multimedia Instruction Strategies for Teaching Learning Process, written by Kirwadkar A and Pushpanatham K, published by Sarup and Sons, New Delhi in the year 2005. Thank you for watching this program. We can meet again with another topic. Till then, take care.